here has never seen improv before.
Me clap.
Yeah, make a clapping sound. So for you guys, and as a refresher for everybody else, improv is totally, utterly, 100% made up on the spot. What you're gonna see out here has never been done before.
Never rehearsed.
Not
written.
No, not written. No.
No.
No. No.
What else? But mine.
Is that it? Okay. We don't know. But it will never be done again, which is pretty cool. So it's like seeing magic being built on this very stage with people.
So tonight, as the headlining act, we have from Chicago, The Boys.
Earth.
Like the wind.
like I want to get back and I want to feel, I just want to be inside the earth.
I want to be like just encapsulated by it, like a big old earthy womb. You know, but with wind. I this really means so much to me, Charles. Thank you. I felt so distant from you lately.
Yeah.
I mean, it's kind of reconnecting. It's really important, you know. So much connection.
I'm sorry I cheated on you. I'm sorry. Just feel the wind. Just let the wind and just forget about Charlotte.
Yeah, you keep talking about her.
I mean, just forget about Charlotte and her red hair.
Charlotte and her hair and her smell, that she smelled like strawberries.
She smelled like strawberries. The hair is red and the wind.
I'm really working on getting over it.
It.
You know,
oh,
just working really hard on that. I just want to
get over it.
Closed and
got in there.
production.
It was spring break. Probably. Okay. Probably. But that's the thing, but it's not sperm I'm buying.
Welcome. We don't have any tequila. We're all out of tequila. Fresh out.
Okay. What do you want instead?
Yeah. I mean, I didn't want tequila.
We've got a really nice rum.
How do you feel about
rum? Ooh, rum's bad. Can't do
what,
rum.
What happens when you drink rum?
That rum was 3 years ago. Cabo. Christmas break.
Bobo Cabo, that was you?
Yeah. Yeah, every time I go back to Cabo, they call me Bobo.
Accountant.
I
lot of promise.
Guys, if I'm going to be the DP here, okay, that's the director of photography.
Why are you explaining that? We're art students.
I know you're art students, but I feel the need to compulsively tell you. Okay. Yeah,
All right, explaininator.
Okay.
Good one.
All right, go ahead. And action, roll!
Actually, I want to see how your film's doing.
Okay.
What are you doing there?
Cutting carrots.
You're doing so good, Charles. That's what I was supposed to say.
Keep going, we're filming.
Oh,
no. Sometimes I don't know. Oh, sorry.
No, yeah. That movie was like an introductory improv scene.
It was
world for under $10. For two people. I Googled it.
We also have some amazing workshops tomorrow. Starting in the morning and the afternoon. We won't tell you how early they start, don't worry about that. And also on Sunday. And some of the workshops will be taught by some people you're going to see here soon.
Yeah, all of that's true.
So, should we welcome to the stage?
Yeah, do we want to give them a chant?
Yes.
I love chants. We have this side of the room go, the! Everyone's coming. And if we have this side of the room go, boys! Fucking do that.
What?
They can't.
They fucking can't because my
my sister. Remember, she had huge tits and it was like 10D? And then she got the third youngest breast reduction in the history of fucking United States. And my mom said, I don't care, my kid's a fucking freak. She couldn't even pick up the wash. My sister had areolas like this. They were like creamy baby head size. And they made them down to be like quarters. No, sacagaweas, maybe a little more. I'm so angry. I should be in fucking gym right now getting off this regression. That's how angry, because I used to have tantrums. I've got no tantrums no more, Gerald. You're the only one who brings that out of me. You bring that anger so much that I want to stuff your tiny dick in my mouth.
So mad. That's what I'm talking about. Come on, let's go behind the field house. They're done painting it for homecoming.
No, they're not done. That means it's going to be all like, I'm going to be doing this, you're going to be doing that, we're going to end up with paint all over our hands. Everybody knows that's the dick sucking. Nobody's going to fucking do that. Remember when Miss McGillicarn and Mr. Saratino used to fuck out there and stuff?
Yes!
Oh, that's fresh paint everywhere.
Oh my god! Oh my god. Oh my god, they fuck so much.
They did fuck so much. They always had white pants on. I mean, like wet paint on the pants. What did I say, white pant? I'm having a stroke. Today, shall we?
Yeah.
Well, here's the thing. You're here to lose weight and feel better about yourself.
Who's ready to get fit?
Now, Shelly's lost almost enough weight to get the skin reduction surgery.
I have.
So no more flapping on the tennis courts. Hello, Pedaza Arms. So you guys probably have some questions about the first day of camp.
It's normal.
Yeah. And who here's about to get their period for their first time?
Don't be embarrassed.
Because Shelly has them always pads with wings.
Yeah.
You're not going to fly away.
The tampons give me toxic shock.
Yeah. Thank you.
The idea my vagina makes a fist.
Okay. I was going to mention, Shelly, thank you for reminding me. Like girls who are older who use tampons, every 2.5 hours you must change those
That's
things.
Right. And you girls with diva cups.
Yes. Right. Yeah. It's not Jesus
right.
pouring
and
one.
It's not just you, Shoshana.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, well, I don't like those diva cups. It makes me feel like we're going to have a tiny glass of wine.
Goddamn mess. Goddamn mess.
But I will say this. The girls who are using pads, no excuse not to get on the tennis court
That's
for
right.
calisthenics at 6 a.m.
That is right. That is right. Physical exercise is just as important as dieting.
Okay?
Yeah.
No, physical exercise is 30%. The diet is 70%. So if you've noticed,
physical exercise is very much disproportionate. Okay, but still important.
Now, some of you might think that I've gained a little weight, so maybe I'm a little hypocritical this year. I just want to let all of you know it's a small tumor.
It's benign.
I have it. They're gonna weigh. It's something in my ovaries. It's growing. You know, I never had the luxury of childbirth or have wonderful children like you.
Some people don't need them.
We got each other.
Yep.
We got
right
each
it.
Other.
Sure.
But I'm just gonna wait till it grows a little more, and then I'm gonna have it removed, and I'm gonna have it put in a jelly jar for the infirmary. So when you get sick, you can come and look at it. What else you got on the docket?
Yeah, anyone questions about our
we got a question here.
Itinerary.
Yes, Nathan, yes.
How are you getting assigned our bunks?
How are you getting assigned your bunks?
Have you ever seen The Hunger Games?
I forgot it's Nathan's first year. Your older brother was here last year, huh?
Your brother didn't fill you in?
Yeah.
Oh.
Excuse me.
Sorry about that. Car accident? Drunk driver? Methamphetamine? Transvestite? Super hot.
About your bunk soon enough, okay?
That's right.
That's right.
Any other questions?
Most I've touched a man and God knows.
Any other questions
about this summer? Oh, there's another one here.
Yes,
Tiffany.
Tiff. Oh, Tiffany
no, that's
Blue.
Roger. Okay,
Tiff.
Yes,
Tiff.
When is our cheat day?
When?
Oh, you fat bitch.
We had a cheat day last year, November 22nd.
We lost three kids. We ran out of insulin. It was
horrible. Let me tell you something about this. I cheated. I'm going to be honest with you. I was naked sobbing on a cold tile floor. That's not cheap. Let's have a solid boobie, okay? Can you or may you?
May I?
There you go. No. my mom will pick me up real soon. She knows it's pickup time.
Well, since my stepdad isn't here either, we might as well make the best of it.
Your stepdad's in prison. It's okay. My mom will pick up both of us. She always says, I'm going to strap you to the top of the VW bug. It's a joke.
Do you want to come to my house?
Oh, I don't know. Everybody says it's a weird house.
It's just because we have orange carpet.
That's not what makes it weird. I think it was the fact that there were murders there. With your stepdad and all. No offense. But my mom's, I'm quite sure she's not drinking now. It's this afternoon, and she needs to stay awake and alert during homework time. And if she doesn't stay awake and alert, she's taking a nap. And then I'll eat Hot Pockets and drink Gatorade. Because it's the thirst aid and makes her feel better in the morning. But I won't drink it all because she needs to feel better in the morning so I can get to school.
My dad!
Your real dad or your stepdad? My real father was murdered. I'm sure he's thinking hard about what he did that was wrong. Because we need to do something
better. He murdered a whole family and left us for dead and thought I was dead too.
Well, you know. Well, that's good. Because otherwise I wouldn't have a friend. A real friend. And that's you.
Thanks for considering me a friend.
I really do. Maybe because nobody, we smell like trouble. That's the thing. We don't need help aides. We don't need them for the schoolwork. They need them for like the sociological struggles we go through on a daily basis. Psychological problems. And I don't think either of us have acted out all school year, but it's nice to know we have an adult next to us who cares.
I genuinely need help. I cannot remember who's supposed to pick me up right now.
Well, everybody in your family's murdered but your stepdad.
And he isn't too. But killing my family!
So have you been released under whose care? And should you know that? Don't you have a foster family? Or an aunt or an uncle who enjoy you?
My inner monologue is mostly I couldn't save mommy.
That's tough to live with. I like to live with positive affirmations like, this morning mommy will wake up.
Oh, I could have saved mommy. I could have saved mommy. I could have saved mommy.
No, it's gotta be positive. Like, it's your time.
That's beautiful.
Yeah, like my cousin Phoebe said, like her dad died young, and she said, oh, he had like a short string is like a baby, a medium string is like a 48-year-old, and a long string is like my grandpa Murray, who lasted until he was 99 years old, and he was in perfect health until he was 98. Your mom had a slightly medium string.
That was stabbed out.
He could hear you, scissors. He might have just cut it.
I think that's stabby.
Yeah, words. I'm sure my mom will be.
Do you wanna play a guessing game?
Sure. Okay, you think of something, I'll think about it, okay?
Okay.
Hold on. Esophagus.
That's where my mother was stabbed.
Okay, I'll think of something right now, okay?
Okay. Ralph Macchio.
Yes. Yes. See, that is why we're friends. We really think of, have you ever seen Brittany and her sister? They're Abby and Brittany. They're co-joined twins. You ever see them on TLC?
I thought they were hugging.
No. Sorry, I just realized I was
my gonna, mom is still dead.
I know, I was gonna say if your mom wasn't sleeping, and I was like, she's sleeping forever. But I was was thinking, if your mom, like, oh, sorry, when my mom is sleeping, I can watch any TV I want.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
What do you watch?
I watch Abby and Brittany, they're conjoined twins. They have two heads on one body.
They're hugging.
No, they're not hugging. Hugging is this. They don't have this arm or this arm. You have that hand and that hand. And they like drive together and they have one vagina. And one day they're gonna have to marry two men and have like sign up lists. But they're religious, so they'll wait a long time. Speaking of which, I'm waiting for my mom.
I don't know what I'm waiting for now.
It's like, Andrew, I still haven't found what I'm looking for. It shows up on my mom's phone. YouTube shows up on my mom's phone like magic. All the time, I didn't even sign up for it, or neither did she. She doesn't know how to use her phone.
I think all of the Edge's guitar whiffs sound the same.
What?
Nothing!
Are you leaving?
Excuse me. Yeah.
Are you leaving?
I am.
You got a fucking hall pass?
Mitzvah 69.
I'm Shana Halayla Zemikov.
I'm sorry.
I'm so drunk. What?
I know. This one started at what time did you start?
Oh, God.
Oh, my God. I almost picked my nose.
I set an alarm, had a mimosa, went back to bed, and woke up.
There you go. Oh, my God. Oh my God, it's like a Princess Diana ring.
Oh my God, Tracy, wait for me.
I can't. Hey, you got your power. Stacy.
Tracy, wait, get out of the fucking way!
Out loud. You know those words you never say out loud?
lesbos?
Yes.
Are they now all lesbians?
No.
Oh, that's sad. We're not making a refugee quilt. We're making
that should be our next volunteer project.
Absolutely. I don't know how this is going to stretch over a football field. We had an entire
No, there's people all over town sewing small quilts they're going to make into a giant quilt.
Well, why wouldn't they come to your house, Rhonda?
not a town's worth of people could fit in my sunken living room.
Yes, I would say at least 7 women could fit in here. You know what? I'm going to invite women to your home, and they're going to come because I invited them, and I'm a nice person.
Well, that's very nice of you.
Now, everybody talks about your divorce.
When we lost our son after his blood transfusion, we were still outcast. And my husband,
let's stop for a second.
Yes.
We didn't lose him in the sense of he died. He wandered off and you had to
I went to pick him up and he was not dead.
Let's
talk for days.
You know what? That's just called bad parenting.
It is.
It's not tragedy. It's on you.
That is why my portion of the AIDS quilt is a magnifying glass.
But that's not your son. Your son didn't die of AIDS. Who? I thought
we don't know. He could have gotten it from the blood transfusion. It was the 90s.
Well, I'm saying, you know what? It was a tragedy. He did have hemophilia, and that is a tragedy. But we're not making a hemophilia quilt. We are making an AIDS quilt. Let's get back to the source.
You want to go to Africa?
No, I was just thinking I would like to go back to the theater. I love the theater.
Oh, I remember watching you in that play in high school. You were so good.
I remember, Mama. I remember thinking to myself, I had little tingly feelings, and I was like, is it because I was just on the stage, or did you invade my personal space? And then I kind of brushed that off, went to college, ignored those feelings there too, and married my lovely husband. I didn't knock this through, so that's why it's coming through.
You've been sewing for like 30 minutes.
I was fine, and then I had to use a different color of thread. And since I use a different color of thread, you have to knot it. And if you knot it, it doesn't stay. It's like building a foundation of a family, something you might not understand. I can't believe you're drinking boxed wine in the middle of the day.
I can't believe a lot of things.
What do you really want, Ron? I mean, we're just sitting here alone. Nobody comes to your house. Why don't you tell your only friend about what you're really thinking?
I'm sad.
Okay, but you can't lie to yourself anymore. We didn't lose your son. You lost your son. You know what I mean?
The hospital lost my son. I was there on time to pick him up.
You should have been there in the room. That's the way it works. You always gotta be in the...
I'm sure my mom will be here.
It's starting to get dark now.
Yeah. You know, you can think of it in negative ways.
Butterfly!
That means your mom is thinking about you. I'm gonna sing a song right now.
Okay.
I wish I were a butterfly, I'd fly up high up in the sky. I wish I were a butterfly, I'd fly away with you. Wish I were a bird, I'd sing the prettiest song you heard. Oh, such a song of hope and joy and love I'd sing to you. I wish I were a star so I could shine my love afar. And then, no matter where you are, I'd show my love on you. We sang this at Camp Kenwood. I lost 30 pounds that time.
I never went to camp.
That's nice. Well, everyone I know is dead. Thank you for being my friend.
Thank you for being my friend.
Thank you for saying that pretty stuff.
Yeah, you know what I was thinking to myself? When you're older, maybe you should get a breast reduction.
Really, what I want is a nipple reduction. Yeah,
I love those. They can take a preemie baby nipple.
Mine are like a triple stack of pancakes, like nipple.
Regression therapy.
That sounds weird.
No, you can go back and find out what happened and things you blocked in your life.
That sounds extra scary.
No.
I don't know if I want to do it. I don't know if I want to do it.
You
want to
what?
Want to do it. Regression therapy?
Don't you want to go back to a time when you were happy?
I was happy.
And you had a family?
I was. But then it ended horribly.
Yeah, you know, your stepfather's just thinking about things.
He's going to have a long time to think about it. And maybe they'll overturn the death penalty. Who knows?
Justin, well, you know, he did such a heinous thing. There's a lawyer that was reading a magazine in the psychiatrist's lobby.
He killed my baby brother.
Yeah.
And my older brother.
Who's that lawyer? Who's
the
lawyer? Who's the lawyer who represents all the bad people?
Oh yeah, she's awesome. She did Ted Kaczynski.
Yeah, she's like so.
Zonar just her soy basket bomb.
Yeah. He killed more people than your stepfather. I'm sure she'll take him on.
No, he only killed three people.
Right.
He injured 250.
What I'm saying is that, like, that woman would be like, that's a piece of cake, walk in the park, your stepfather.
My stepfather killed 15 people.
Are you guys having a party?
Featuring
The boys will be back, as well as Rachel Klein, who is down from Boston, as well as folks who are in the October issue right here in D.C.
It starts at 2 p.m. and it's free, but you can reserve tickets online.
Yes.
And speaking of wit, we should thank Washington Improv Theater for allowing us to have the festival at Source. We couldn't do it forever.
Also, if you like the cool swag that Saban are wearing, Woo! You could own it.
Or
you could cut it yourself. Like this. You want to check out our Wear Sun t-shirts and koozies.
Did you guys know the Z was capitalized in it? I'm sorry?
The Z is capitalized in koozie. Fun fact. Feel free to buy some. And also, if you want to join us, we're going to the Feeding Goat afterwards. So everyone's welcome to come join us. You guys are a wonderful audience.